गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट वर्क। चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट इज वर्क? सो वर्क इज सेड टू बी डन व्हेन ए फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन ए ऑब्जेक्ट एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्प्लेस्ड इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स। द वर्क डन on an object is the product of the force applied and the displacement. So work done equal to force into displacement, that is W equal to F into S. The unit of work is joule, J. If capital F is the 1 Newton and displacement is 1 meter, then the work done is 1 Newton meter or 1 joule. So 1 joule is the amount of work done when a force of 1 Newton displaces on an object by 1 meter. For example, if a force of 5 Newtons acts on an object is displaced through 2 meters in the direction of force, then the work done is 5 Newtons in 2 meters equal to 10 Newton meters or 10 joules. The work done by a force may be positive or negative. The work done by a force is positive if the force and displacement are in the same direction. The work done by a force is negative if the force and the displacement are passed opposite direction. The work done by a force is zero if there is no displacement. The work done by a force is zero if the force is perpendicular to the displacement. Example, when we lift an object, the object moves upward in the direction of force. Here the work done is positive, but there is the force of gravity acting downwards on the object. The work done by the force of gravity is negative. For example, a porter lifts a luggage of 15 kg from the ground and puts it on his head 1.5 meters above the ground. Calculate the work done by him on the luggage. So mass of the luggage, children, m equal to 15 kg, displacement equal to 1.5 meters, acceleration due to gravity is equal to 10 meters per second. Work done W equal to F into S, or mg into s equal to 15 kg into 10 meters per second into 1.5, therefore 225 kilograms per meter second square equal to 225 newtons meter or equal to 225 joules. Now what is energy? The energy of an object is its capacity for doing work. The unit of energy is the same as that of work, that is joule. 1 joule is the energy required to do 1 joule of work. 1000 joules equal to 1 kilojoule. There are different forms of energy. They are heat energy, light energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, potential energy, plus kinetic energy, etc. Now, what is kinetic energy? The kinetic energy of an object is the energy possessed by the object due to its motion. All moving objects possess kinetic energy. A falling coconut, a speeding car, a flying aircraft, flowing water, blowing wind, a running athletes, etc. possess kinetic energy. The kinetic energy of an object depends upon its speed. An object is moving faster has more kinetic energy than an object moving slower. The kinetic energy possessed by an object of mass m and moving with uniform velocity v is Ek equal to half into mv square. So example, children, an object of mass 15 kg is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meter per second. What is the kinetic energy possessed by an object? Mass of the object m equal to 15 kg, velocity of the object v equal to 4 meter per second, then Ek is equal to half into mv square. Substitute the values in the equation, Ek is equal to half into mv square. So half into 15 kg into 4 meter per square into 4 meter per square. So is equal to, if you cancel the terms, and you get the answer, the kinetic energy of the object is 120 joules. Next topic, potential energy. The potential energy of an object is the energy possessed by the object due to its position or shape. For example, if a rubber band is stretched and then released, it regains its original position. When the rubber band is stretched, energy is transferred to it. and stored as potential energy. If you wind the key of a toy car and place it on the ground, it moves. When you wind the key of the car, energy is transferred to the spring inside and stored as potential energy. If we lift an object to a height and release it, it falls down. When the object is lifted, energy is transferred to it and stored as potential energy. So potential energy of an object is at height. When object is raised to a height, its energy increases because work is done on it against gravity. The energy present in such an object is called gravitational potential energy. If an object of mass m is raised to a height h from the ground, the force required to raise the object is equal to the weight of the object mg. So work done equal to force to displacement. So R W equal to mg into h or mgh. So potential energy gained by the object Ep equal to mgh. So one example sum is given, children, here. Find the energy possessed by an object of mass 10 kg when it is at height of 6 meters above the ground, given g equal to 10.8 meter per second. Mass of the object m equal to 10 kg, displacement ih is equal to 6 meters. Acceleration due to gravity g equal to 10.8 meter per second. Potential energy Ep equal to mgh. Substitute the values in the equation, you'll get the answer 588 joules. Transformation of energy. The conversion of energy from one form into another form is called transformation of energy. So children, transformation of energy means the conversion of energy from one form into another form is called transformation of energy. When energy is converted from one form into another, the total energy always remains the same. So whenever the energy is converted from one form into another, the total energy always remains the same. Law of conservation of energy. The law of conservation of energy states that energy can only be converted from one form into another form. It can neither be created nor destroyed. The total energy before and after the transformation remains the same. This is about law of conservation of energy. So one example given, let an object be allowed to fall freely from a height. At the start, the potential energy is more. As it falls down, the potential energy changes into kinetic energy. The potential energy decreases and the kinetic energy increases when the object is about to reach the ground. The kinetic energy is the largest and the potential energy is the least, but the sum of the potential energy and kinetic energy is the same at all points. So potential energy plus kinetic energy is equal to constant. The sum of the potential energy and kinetic energy is the total mechanical energy. So rate of doing work, power. Power is the rate of doing work. If W is the work done in time T, then power equal to work done by time taken, or P equal to W by T. The unit of power is what? W. 1 watt is the power of an agent which does work at the rate of 1 joule per second. So 1 watt equal to 1 joule per second, or 1 watt equal to 1 joule per second. 1 kilowatt equal to 1000 watts. 1 kilowatt equal to 1000 watts. 1 kilowatt equal to 1000 joules per second. So commercial unit of power. The commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is the energy used in 1 hour at the rate of 1 kilowatt or 1000 joules per second. 1 kilowatt hour equal to 1 kilowatt hour into 1 hour. So 1000 watts into 1 hour, 1000 watts into 3600 seconds. So total is equal to 36000 joules. So 1 kilowatt equal to 3.6 into 10 power minus 6 joules. The electric energy used in homes and industries are expressed in kilowatt hour. The electric energy used during a month is expressed in units. Here 1 unit means 1 kilowatt hour. Thank you and have a nice day.